Today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you got to do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Backbeat, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you've never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads we have to walk are winding, and all the lights that lead us there are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Because maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. Today was gonna be the day, but they'll never throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you're not to do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads that lead you there were winding, and all the lights that light the way are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. I said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. Then maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. I said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. You're gonna be the one that saves me. You're gonna be the one that saves me.
Wow, well there you go. What a top tune. And that was Wonderwall, originally, of course, by Oasis. And a couple of weeks ago, I heard that tune at a Manchester City match when City beat Tottenham. And obviously, Oasis, famously Manchester City supporters, so it's quite regular and quite common for Oasis tunes to be played at City games. And Manchester City is quite something, really. It's a family heirloom, because we pass it down through generation to generation in our family. My dad and his dad used to go and watch City one week and United the other week, but they always felt that they were more drawn towards Manchester City, which is good. I mean, it kind of shaped my dad's support, and that cascaded to me and my brother. So my dad could have, if he'd have favoured United, you know, I'd be sat here now in a red shirt. And it's that family tradition. So my first game was in the 1977-78 season. My dad took me and my brother to the old stadium at Main Road. City won 3-2, and it was the most incredible experience of my life up to that point. The colour of the green grass when I first walked in and saw the pitch, the floodlights were on. It was a Saturday afternoon game, but it was in the winter, so the floodlights were on from before kickoff, and the greenness of the grass was just phenomenal. It was incredible. and the noise, the sounds, the what I was seeing. I was looking around the stand because it was in the Platt Lane end. We were sat on wooden benches, and could just see cigarette lighters going throughout the first half, like paparazzi flash bulbs. It was incredible. And it was just a fantastic, I would say, life-changing experience. And City have been with me from that day forward, really. And they've always been there as a place to go, a bit of escapism. You know, even if you're having a crap time in life, that escapism for 90 minutes, Manchester City have always been there. And it's quite good. It's a family tradition, and I've carried on that tradition myself. My son, he came to his first City game. City won 6-0, and it was beautiful. Sun was shining, everything, goals flying in every, you know, all over the place, and it was such a good, it was just such a good experience, and to feel that and to share that. And my brother has also done the same with his son. You know, my brother and his son also avid City supporters. So it's whoever is in the family, you know, seems to just find their way to being a Manchester City supporter. It's uncanny that, isn't it? But obviously City, since they've had new owners, have had success and won trophies, and it's incredible. It's like, I can't imagine. But there is still a part of me that reminisces about the bad old days and what it was to struggle. And just to win a match was an achievement for City. You know, go there, you wouldn't know whether City would win, lose or draw. Not quite the same now. But what I do recall is that all the players, all the boys that have gone before who've played for City are still equally significant to me in terms of the City history and the City heritage. City have had some amazing players. I mean, still Kevin De Bruyne, one of the best players in the world. Sergio Aguero, the best player I've ever seen for City. And David Silva, the second best player I've ever seen for City. And throw in the likes of Bernardo Silva, Yaya Toure, Ilkay Gundogan, Sami Nasri, Riyad Mahrez. There's loads of players in there who kind of deserve honourable mentions from recent times. But if you go back to before the good old days, you know, when things were, you know, sometimes quite grim, there's players like Andy Morrison and Ali Benarbi. What a most incredible player Ali Benarbi was. He would have fitted in the City team of today because he was so gifted at his peak. Nicky Weaver, Paul Dickoff, Kevin Horlock. You know, these players are just as important in the City story for me. And then if you go further back from that, one of my favourite players of all time is Uwe Rösler. Uwe Rösler and Vincent Kompany from more recent times, they're my favourite two players. And it's their effort, their energy, how they put themselves across when they were playing, but also off the field, they conducted themselves brilliantly. And those two guys are absolute heroes for me. Uwe and Vincent, they're just incredible people. And then going back further in time, my first City team, you know, had the likes of Joe Corrigan, Tommy Booth, Paul Power, Dennis Stewart, Peter Barnes, Gary Owen, Willie Donaghy, Asa Hartford. And they're all special players in the City history too. And I know before that, before I started watching City, there's people that are famous and seem to get mentions in the City past. But there's also the likes of Neil Young, Glyn Pardo, Alan Oakes, Harry Dowd. There's people like that, a bit of the unsung heroes. We all know about Colin Bell, Franny Lee, and Mike Sumby. But, you know, those other players are really significant. You know, as is Bert Trautman, as is Frank Swift. City has got so much history. It's such an incredible football club. And thankfully, through my family connection, through the fact that we're a City family, I've got a bit of that connection. I feel a tiny grain of sand in the Sahara Desert, but I'm a little tiny part of Manchester City, and it's incredible because City is an absolutely special and unique club. It really is. So there you go. Right, I've spoke for long enough. So there's Manchester City, and there's Oasis, big fans of City too. So hopefully you've enjoyed me reminiscing and effervescing about my favourite football team in England. Hopefully you enjoyed the song. So there's nothing much more for me to say other than thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed it, and hopefully you'll join me next time. So until then, I'll say goodbye for now.